Hello dreamers, how are you doing? Recently, I've seen a lot of posts and comments about Canada not needing the immigrants anymore, at least in the near future. When saying that, people give points in support of their statements, points like the recession, the millions of jobs that are being lost, about the all program draws that are not conducted anymore since last 3 months. So people quote all of these points and then they say that Canada does not need immigrants anymore, or maybe at least in the near future. So is this true? We'll talk about it in this video. Don't go anywhere. I'll be right back. Okay, so let's start with those points that are the real problem. Why people actually say that immigrants might not be needed in Canada in the near future. And after that, we will discuss some other points and I'll try to convince you for the message that I'm going to deliver through this video to you all. So the first point that people quote is jobs. Around 3 million jobs were lost in the month of March and April. So people say that obviously the Canadian government would want the Canadians to fill up those job vacancies first, and then they'll take care of the immigrants. In a sense, it's true. The good news is that this 3 million jobs lost or more was until the month of March and April. When we got the report of the employment report of May in the month of June, then we got to know that around 300K or 300,000 jobs were gained back only in the month of May. Now, in the month of May, most of the Canada was still closed. However, just like Ontario, few stores were allowed to open. Those were like those general stores, or maybe some grocery stores, or maybe some retail stores that had some opening over the road, not in the shopping mall. Now, in the month of June, Ontario has just entered the second stage of its reopening, and by that they mean the malls are now open, the saloons are now open, the restaurants are now open, everything is being opened slowly but with a lot of caution. So I'm pretty sure when we get the employment report of the month of June, it will be even much better than the month of May. Will those 3 million jobs be gained in this 2-3 months? Definitely not. And that's why I have said multiple times in my earlier videos as well that 2020 is not the year to arrive and settle in Canada as an immigrant. It would not be very easy, it would be difficult, but yes, it would be a choice if you want to come here in the year of 2020. Okay, now when we have talked about the jobs, it's very important to talk about the number of coronavirus cases. Has the curve flattened here in Canada or not? So yes, the good news is the curve has already flattened here in Canada. In the last few weeks, the number of new cases reported all around Canada has been pretty low. And just yesterday, only around 300 new cases were reported all around Canada, when in the month of March or April, it was above 2000 every day. So that is something very significant, and that is helping the people and the government to grow their economy back. That is helping people to go out and so that they can do the spending. That is the reason why the Canadian economy will get better soon. And that is the reason why the jobs will be regained very soon. But what does that mean to you? So obviously, as I told you in my earlier video, everything is interconnected. When the jobs are regained, it might take a few months or maybe an year by the spring of 2021 that we get to the same pace back again. But yes, soon after that, you can see a spike in the immigration as well. I'll come back to this point, but before that, let me talk about the other very important point, which is the all program draws not being conducted since last 3 months. So as you know, IRCC has only been conducting express entry draws only for CEC and PNP applicants, all those people who have got a good score and sitting outside Canada who haven't got any PNP invite or Canadian work experience have not been able to get the invite or the ITA. So that is true for now. But hopefully, as the conditions are evolving around the world, things are getting better here in Canada as well. We really hope that Canada and IRCC would be issuing ITAs to other people as well. It may be the last of June or July, but definitely it is coming very soon. Okay, now to answer the main question that I've put up through this video, I want to ask you another question. Why do you think Canada invites immigrants? Why do you think Canada needs immigrants? Do they do a favor on you? Think about it. They have set a target of 1 million immigrants in 3 years. And they keep revising this target and they increase the numbers even more. Just think about the numbers. They invite 3,900 people every 14 days, which means around 270 to 280 people every day. And most of these immigrants come from countries like India, China, Pakistan, maybe Indonesia, all of these countries which are underdeveloped countries. Why is it so? Do you think that Canada is doing a favor on you? Certainly not. They are doing this because they have an aging population. They are doing this because they know that their population is getting old and the birth rate is very low. That is the reason why they want to make sure that their labor force needs are met in the upcoming years. And when I say upcoming years, they mean by next 5 years, 10 years or 15 years. They don't talk about 2020 or next few months only. They talk about a long time. So this is what the key factor is. When governments make plans for immigration or stuff like that, they take into consideration a longer future, not just few months or maybe a couple of years. They talk about 2025, 2030, 2040. And when I talk about 2025, 2030, coronavirus, jobs lost, maybe the recession will be all history. And they would still need millions of immigrants from around the world. Their strategy is very clear and clever. They pick up the creamy layer from there because obviously they have set up their structure like that, that you would get more points for higher studies, you'd get more points for more work experience. So obviously they're kind of gathering the more skilled people from countries like India, Pakistan, China, all of these countries. They're just picking up the most skilled immigrants from those countries, obviously, who are interested to come to Canada. So that is the reason why Canada needs immigrants. And when we talk about, you know, immigrants intake and stuff like that, in that case, we don't talk about next few months or next maybe couple of years even. We talk about long term. So Canada would definitely need immigrants in the upcoming years. Immigrants would be the driving force for Canada's economy to grow. And apart from that, there's one more point also. As an immigrant, when we come over from our home country to Canada, we bring a lot of money. As an Indian, we are supposed to bring around 7-8 lakh rupees, even if we are a single guy. If we are a family of 2 or 3, we might have to bring around 10-12 lakh rupees, right? So you're bringing that money from your home country and then you're spending it over here. So that will help the Canadian economy grow. Similarly, all the international students, they are charged almost double the amount of fees that a Canadian student would actually pay. So talking just about international students, they bring in billions of dollars in fees and in the expenses that they do here in Canada, which Canada or any other country actually needs at this moment. Do you think that Canada would want to lose all of that money? Definitely not. Let me show you a recent statement by the Canadian Immigration Minister and what he has to say about the intake of immigrants even after this coronavirus pandemic. Right, so this is the article where they have discussed about the press release that came out from the Federal Minister for Immigration. He has clearly said that immigration drives economic growth, spurs innovation, and helps employers access the talent that they need to thrive. Again, addressing the aging population, he has said that if we have a prolonged stop, that could really hurt us 10 years from now. Immigrants tend to be much younger. Without an influx, we'll become a very old country, and that's a very expensive proposition. We need to be thinking about how we can turn immigration system back on. We can't just go into this turtling, not letting people in, because it's such an important piece of our growth. So I guess just from these statements from the press release, it is quite clear that Canada would be resuming the influx of immigrants very soon, and definitely it is not going to stop anytime soon in the next one decade. Alright, so thank you so much guys for watching this video. I just hope that the message is pretty clear that Canada would still need immigrants in the upcoming years. It's not about a short-term goal, it's about a long-term goal. So don't believe on this false news. Keep preparing for IELTS. If you are there in your home country and you want to come to Canada, maybe this year is not the right time. So prepare for next year. So anyways, when you come here next year or maybe after that, you would face fierce competition because this recession is going to last a bit longer. And obviously there would be some struggle, but definitely Canada would need immigrants in the years to come. So thank you guys for watching this video. If you like the video, please click the thumbs up button. If you have any feedback and any comment, please put it down in the comment section below. And yes, if you haven't subscribed my channel yet, what are you waiting for? Please click the subscribe button before moving on to the next video. Thanks again.